Hello there, very good morning to you. You're watching Proactive London and joining us today from Centamin, it is the Chief Financial Officer with us, Ross Jerrard. A warm welcome to you, Ross.
Hi, Katie, good morning.
Very good morning. So I thought we'd kickstart the conversation by talking about something that everybody is talking about right now, and that is, of course, inflation. Tell us how you're managing to mitigate this.
Thanks, Katie. Yes, I think it's fair to say that when we came up with our cost guidance at the beginning of the year, people were surprised at how we were looking at costs. But as we stand at the half year, I'm glad to report that we're actually basically on track in terms of where we thought we were with our internal metrics. Yes, we are experiencing inflation, as everybody is globally, but I think there's a few key points that are worthy of note. We launched a continuous improvement program the best part of 18 months ago. This was an initiative to extract $150 million of sustainable costs from the business. Mm-hmm. And I'm glad to say that we are on track with that program, having achieved $78 million of the $150 million delivered to date. Some of these key initiatives that are worth mentioning are our solar plant, where we're just completing the installation of a 36 megawatt solar plant on the mine, which is expected to save $25 million a year at current fuel prices. We've recently transitioned our underground operation from contractor mining to owner-operator mining, and that's going to save us $15 million a year. And we've also converted our whole open pit mining fleet to lightweight truck trays, which reduces fuel usage and increases load capacity. So there are a raft of initiatives across the business, including tying into grid power and the like. But I think recognizing inflation early, managing it, and this program that was launched 18 months ago, we're now really seeing the benefits of that program coming through. And it's important that we keep cadence on that whole program across the business.
Mm-hmm. All right, Ross, let's maybe move on and talk about last month's second quarter results, shall we? Because the company's significant reinvestment in Sukari, it's starting to bear fruit now, really, with production and revenue up, costs down as well. Could you maybe talk a bit about this reinvestment, you know, what projects you've been invested in, and maybe what's required to realize the company's ambitions?
Sure. Yes, we took the decision to reinvest in the Sukari mine and reset the mine for the longer term, remembering that we've already been in production for over 10 years, and we've got at least another 10 years in front of us. Key initiatives included resetting the open pit. We launched a waste stripping program and getting the open pit back into a fit state, giving us the operational flexibility for the longer term. We brought the underground operations in-house, as I've mentioned previously, but also we invested in our underground development and drilling programs. So by bringing it, the operations in-house, that reduced our costs by 20%. But the drilling program and the investment gave us an increase in our reserves, which gave us the visibility for the long term, which gave us the confidence that we were able to invest future capex and giving us the visibility on those long-term investment decisions. I think with the cost program now delivering that I've mentioned, and with ounce profiles going back up, those two in conjunction brings our cost profile back below that $1,000 all-in sustaining cost level, which is ultimately where we're targeting what we want to achieve over the next 2 years.
All right, let's talk about this capital structure review that is underway right now. So you're considering taking on debt. This is something that's new and not been done before, I understand. So maybe explain why you're considering doing this. What would be the short-term and long-term impacts on shareholders as well, maybe?
Okay, yes, we're currently undertaking a capital structure review, which is assessing operational cash flows across different scenarios in the business, capital allocation opportunities to support our growth objectives, and looking at a mix of debt and dividend policy and distributions. So with the greater confidence that we've got over the longer term, because of this mine plan and the underground and the reset, we're looking at what has traditionally been considered probably quite a conservative view in terms of a balance sheet position and holding a very high treasury position. So we're looking at introducing a sensible level of debt that provides us that optionality to finance certain projects. Some of these we're able to cost recover on a priority basis if we're investing into our Sukari mine. But we're able to do this without impacting on shareholders, and we're going to be able to manage it to the same level of liquidity, but just with a combination of sensible cash and debt rather than purely cash. I think the other important point to note is that having a bank facility with a syndicate of banks builds that relationship for future objectives. As we're looking to develop and finance on some of our other projects more broadly and possibly M&A. So I think what it means to shareholders is that we can balance returns across both of our objectives, which are growth and dividend returns, where in the past we've probably been focused more just solely on dividend itself. So in summary, I guess our intention is to announce this capital allocation framework during the third quarter, balancing both growth and dividend returns, but being able to manage that on a through the cycle basis.
All right. Thank you very much indeed. That's Ross Jerrard, the Chief Financial Officer from Centamin here on Proactive London.
Thank you.